In this video, we're going to start the CUDA software Infinite Geometry free worksheet line segment constructions. Now, an important part of construction is that we're not necessarily going to be using numbers to calculate these lengths or angles and such. We're just going to be using a compass, a pencil, and a straight edge. So if we're constructing a line segment congruent to the given line segment, looking at number one, we want to construct a line segment that's congruent. That means that it's going to be the same measure. So we have our one endpoint, and I'm going to draw endpoint of my other line that I'm going to be constructing. Now from that endpoint, I'm going to draw a straight edge that will become my new congruent line. And I'm going to draw it a little bit longer than this line. Now, I'm going to take my compass, place one point of the edge on the end point of the line that's given, and then adjust my compass so that the pencil point sits on the other end point of that given line. Now, without changing my compass, I'm going to move it to the end point of my drawn line, and then mark with that pencil point. And that will be the length of my new line. So I'll just erase the section that I had extended past. And my endpoint will be where that mark intersected my new line. This segment is congruent to this segment. Let's move on to number two. In number two, we're going to construct a line segment whose length is equal to the sum of the lengths of the given line segments. So we're going to be adding the measurements of these segments together. However, we're not going to be using numbers. So I'm going to start with my endpoint, and if I'm adding these together, they're going to form one long segment. So I'm starting with an endpoint, and then I will draw a straight line extending from that endpoint, going further than the addition of those two segments. Now, I'm going to take my compass and line it up on the endpoint of the first segment, taking the pencil point and lining it up on that second endpoint of that first segment given. Now, this is the length of my first segment, so I'm going to place this on my endpoint of my line that I've drawn and mark that with my compass. Now, I'm going to take the measurement of my next line by putting the endpoint of my compass on one point of that second line, and my compass will extend to that second endpoint of that line. Now taking this new line measurement, I'm going to place it where my first measurement ended and then make that mark. So you can see, once I draw my endpoint, that this new line segment is the length of those segments added together. So let me just make this a little more bold by darkening my line. Moving on to number three, it says to construct a line segment whose length is equal to the difference of the lengths of the given line segments. So we're looking for the difference now, so we're going to take that larger line and subtract the smaller line. So first, creating my new endpoint, I'm going to draw a straight line extending off of that endpoint. Now I'm going to take my longer line segment that was given, which is the second segment down, and put my compass points on the edge or on each of the endpoints. Now taking that measurement, I'm going to start on the endpoint that I created and mark my new endpoint. Now I'm going to take the measurement of that first line, and remember we're taking the difference, so we're going to be subtracting this measurement. Now I'm going to place it on the new endpoint that I just created. However, as opposed to going forward on that line, I'm going to go backwards, taking away this amount. So my new endpoint occurs between that previous point I created and my original point. That is the endpoint of my line segment whose length is equal to the difference. So now I erase my line that was extended past, and you can see that this is the length of my new line segment. In number four, it says to construct a line segment the given number of times longer than that given segment. So in number four, it says to construct a line two times as long. So we're going to take this length and essentially multiply it by two, or just add the length to itself. So we're doubling that line. Now I'm going to start with my point, and I'll draw a straight line from that point extending out roughly a little past 2 times as long as I believe that line will be. Now I'm going to take my compass, place the points of my compass on the endpoints of this line. Now I'm going to take the compass as is, move it to the point that I drew, make a mark, and then we're doing 2 times as long as this line. So I'm going to keep that same measurement, place it on the mark I just drew, and then find my new end point. This line segment is 2 times as long as this line segment. Now, number 5, it says to construct a line segment half as long as the given segment. So essentially here, we're going to find the bisector of this line and then take the measurement from that midpoint, essentially where that bisector intersects the line, take the measurement from that to the end point, and that will be half as long. So in order to create a bisector, we first will start by placing 1 point of our compass on the end point and the pencil point of our compass. We're going to move a little past what we believe would be halfway. Now we're going to draw up, make a mark, and then we're going to move our compass spinning down and make a mark. And we're going to do the same thing, not changing our compass length. We're going to go from the other end point, draw up, make our mark, and then draw down and make another mark. Now where those two marks intersect, those points become the end points of the bisector. So we're going to draw a line from each of those intersections. Now from the point of where the bisector intersects our line segment, we're going to put our compass on that center point or midpoint, and then we're going to also place it on the edge of our original line. This is our new measurement of the line segment that will be half as long. But first, let's draw that point of our new line segment and a straight line extending out from that point. Now we're going to take the measurement of that line segment that's half as long and mark that on our line and then adjust our line accordingly. So this mark becomes our new end point, and I will erase what's beyond that end point. So from end point to end point, that is our new line segment that is half as long as the given line segment. Onto the second page, it says to divide each line segment into the number of equal parts specified. So for number 6, we're dividing this into 3 equal parts. Now in order to divide a line into an n number of segments, we're first going to start by drawing a pair of parallel lines. However, it's important how exactly we draw these parallel lines. First, we're going to start by extending a line off the end point of this line. And you're just going to extend it upwards any amount you want. Now, I'm going to divide this line into 3 segments of a given length. So I'm going to pick a measurement. So I'm going to pick approximately a length, roughly eyeballing what I would think would be a third. That's a little more than a finger length width apart. And I'm going to draw that 3 times. So marking once, twice, and then 3 times. Now, in order to make a parallel line, I'm going to find the distance between that last mark and the other end point of my original line, and I'm going to take that distance and draw it off of my first end point. Now I'm going to go back to my new line, zooming out a bit so you can see this. So going back to that line that I drew, going upwards from that first point, I'm going to go all the way to that 3rd tick mark that I made to find the distance or the measurement of that line. So now I'm going to take that length, place my point on the end point of my original segment, and find the intersection. Now I'm just going to connect the end point of this line to the intersection of those 2 marks. And that helps me create a line that's parallel to that first line that I created. Now I'm going to go back to the length of those segments that was a little longer than my fingertip width. So I'm going to go back, line up that measurement, and then once I have that on my compass, I will extend from the end point of my parallel line. 1, 2, and then 3. And you can see that 3 lands on the end point of that line. So now what I'll do, I'll take my straight edge from the first tick mark on each line. That will be one division. And then from the next tick mark, that will be my other division. Let's go from endpoint to endpoint, and then endpoint to endpoint. So you can see that I've divided my original line into 3 equal parts. 1, 2, 3. In number 7, we're constructing a perpendicular bisector of this segment. Now if you remember, we already created a perpendicular bisector in number 5 when we constructed that line bisector. So in order to construct that perpendicular bisector, we need to guess or make an estimate that's a little more than halfway on that line, and then draw a mark above, or in this case to the right, and then do the same below. Now switching endpoints, we're going to repeat that. And you can see I did not quite get an intersection, so I'm going to go back to my original endpoint that I went off of, continue that line, and then continue that line until I have an intersection between those two semi-arcs, or between those two marks. Now, in order to get that perpendicular bisector, I'm going to go from the intersection of my first marks to the intersection of my second marks. And that is how you construct a perpendicular bisector. In number 8, we're going to be locating the midpoint. But remember, the midpoint is where that line segment bisector intersects our original line. So essentially repeating the process from number 7, we're going to place our compass on the endpoint, go a little more than what we believe would be halfway, make a mark above, make a mark below. This time I'm going to make it a little bigger so that I don't have to repeat that intersection. And now go to the other endpoint, make a mark above, make a mark below, and where those two intersect, those will be the endpoints or points along my perpendicular bisector. So I'll go ahead and draw those. But note that we want the midpoint, or where they intersect our original segment. And I'll mark that on my line. And that's how you locate the midpoint of a segment using constructions. On this third page, it tells us to construct a line segment perpendicular to the segment given through the point given. So number 9, our point is on the line segment that's given. So what we're going to do is essentially shorten that segment. So we're going to take our compass, put it on the given point, set your compass slightly away from that point, make a mark on the line, and then go to the other side of the point, not changing the compass measure, and make that same point, or that same mark. Now you can see that we have 2 points that are the same distance from our given point. So our given point essentially is the midpoint of our new segment. One endpoint being here and one endpoint being here. Now we're just going to make that perpendicular bisector. If we know that this is the midpoint, we only need one intersection and then we can connect the two. So like when we create the perpendicular bisector, we're going to put our compass on the endpoint of our line segment, and we're putting on the new endpoint that we just created, extending our compass a little more than halfway, which if this point is halfway, going a little past that point, then making our mark, and then extending from the other endpoint of our new segment, keeping the compass the same measurement, making another mark. The intersection is an endpoint that's on that perpendicular bisector, and that's the perpendicular bisector of our small segment that we created. But if we would connect this intersection point to the point given, that would be a line segment that's perpendicular to the given line segment. So now we'll just draw our line. And here's a line segment that's perpendicular to the given segment. And note that it was a perpendicular bisector if we were to just look at this segment. But it is just a perpendicular segment of the entire line. So it bisects this smaller segment, but overall it is a perpendicular segment. Let's move on to number 10. In number 10, we're constructing a line segment that's perpendicular to the given segment that goes through the given point. So in this case, I'm going to extend this segment, making it a little longer, so that I can make a segment out of that longer line segment. So I'm going to put my endpoint of my compass on the given point, extend my compass out to the line, mark a tick mark, swing it around, and mark it at the other intersection of the line. Now, I have two endpoints for my newly created segment. And again, I'll go through the steps for making a perpendicular segment. However, I have to take this point into account. So I'm going to extend a little further than what I believe halfway is. And instead of making a tick mark on this side, I'm going to go to this opposite side, make my mark, swing it around to the other endpoint that I created, make my other mark, and that intersection will be an endpoint that I connect to my given endpoint. And that segment will be perpendicular to our given segment. Now looking at number 11, I'm going to extend this segment. And then using this given point, I'm going to create a smaller segment like I did in number 9. So now I have that given point is the midpoint of my smaller segment that I've just created. So this segment right here. And then I'm going to move my compass a little more than halfway. So a little past that midpoint, extend my mark, and then go to the other endpoint that I created, and then mark to find the intersection. Now I can extend going through that intersection from the given point to make a perpendicular segment. In number 12, it says to construct a line segment through the given point parallel to the given line segment. In order to do this, we're going to pick a point on our given line segment, say here, and then connect our new point to our given point, creating a new line segment. Now, going from our new point, the intersection of our new line segment, to our original line segment, we're going to extend out, making our compass a little bit smaller than the distance to that next point. Make a mark there, and then make a mark where that line will also intersect. Now, unfortunately, my line wasn't long enough, so I'm going to have to extend this out slightly further. So again, we took a measurement on our compass from the point of that intersection, slightly smaller, up to our given point, made our tick mark, and then, using our given point as our end point, made another tick mark along that line. We need to figure out where this distance intersects our given line, which will be here. So essentially, we're going to make one small arc, and then going from that given point, we're going to do the same, imagining where our parallel line would be, making sure we would be able to intersect that. Now that we have a point here that intersects, we could line our compass up with that first tick mark and find the measurement to the intersection. And once we have that measurement, we'll move up to that second tick mark that we made using our given point that was along that line segment we created, and make the same tick mark, but note that this intersection was on the line that we need to draw a segment parallel to, so this intersection will help us form that new parallel line that goes through our given point. And you can see that those lines are indeed parallel.